Hello, everyone, and happy full moon in Cancer. All right, so the high point for the full moon in my location is 9:48 a.m. So I enjoyed the full moon. I just did a lot of writing and got some clarity. In my area, it's 0 degrees 49 minutes, so as I'm making this, it's still going through that full moon time. So the main message, we're looking at the full moon in Cancer, right? And Cancer is, before I go on, some have been saying the video is too low. Just turn it up because it's, it sounds fine on my end. I think one of my videos, the sound went out. I might redo that video again. I don't know. Anyway. So the full moon in Cancer. Cancer, a water sign, all about compassion. This is the 22nd of December now. So yesterday, the 21st, was the winter solstice. So the sun gets the lowest it will get for the lunar year, or the sun, the solar year. And then by the 25th, it will get higher in the sky and just keeps rising, right, until we get to spring. So this is a great time to really reflect on what we did throughout the whole year, and hopefully we did everything right for the winter. We're talking about the seasons, right, and making sure that we have harvest, we have everything that we need, and we are practicing being grateful and really using our resources wisely. So the gift is really all the work that we did in preparation for winter. That's the true gift, having safety, being in the home. And being that's a full moon in Cancer, check it out. It's about safety, the home, family. And when it's the darkest time of the year, you know, avoiding depression and thinking too much about things, and really, you know, finding peace within yourself so people don't upset you as much as they would like to. So really avoiding any kind of negativity, you know, and making your home peaceful. So I'll be sharing some of this in the workshop that I'm doing tonight, a Reiki workshop. So as soon as I finish this up, I'm heading out the door. So, all right, let's look at Capricorn. The sun is in Capricorn because today starts the Capricorn season, right? And I can even search right now and see when Capricorn season is for this year because it changes. So you might be a day off or on. I like to be as exact as I can. But normally it starts around this time, the 21st to January 20th. So they're claiming it started yesterday, the 21st. All right. But when you look at regular charts, it'll say it starts the 22nd. So each year is a little bit different. So we're in the sun season of Capricorn birthdays. Cancer is your opposite sign. So if you don't relate to things in your zodiac, switch over to see what's going on in your opposite sign and pull from that. We have Saturn, Pluto, the South Node, and the 11th house working with Capricorn, okay? Capricorn's in the 11th house about friends and groups and what you aspire to be within that circle, or what you aspire to be, within your group setting, okay? The South Node is asking you to look at your past, maybe past relationships, things you're comfortable with, okay? Where you come from, what you feel comfortable with, past lives even. So that might even come up in dreams or just in your thought. Now, Saturn is asking you to get in order with yourself for the new year and any kind of restrictions that you need to put in place. This is good because Capricorn opposite Cancer is really asking you to get better at your work, what you're doing with your work, and how are you being too compassionate, too nice, maybe not nice enough, not fair enough. So whatever you're doing that's negative, it's going to come back to you. So make sure you're doing positive things for yourself, and make sure that, you know, you're doing right in your 10th, 11th, and first house. Okay. Also, that's for everyone. Everyone should be making sure that they're in order when it comes to what they aspire to do, what their dreams are, and how they are with their awareness to self, and really how you treat others. Pluto is asking you about your transformation, about your subconscious forces around you, other people, you know, what you don't see that's happening. Okay, maybe you need to have a renewal or a rebirth of something in your life, of yourself, to transform out of that, because maybe you're seeing people for who they are, really are, not what they pretend to be. And this happens to be in the workplace, because these cats are running everywhere. So this is all having to do with in the workplace, or people that you expect to be a certain way, but they're not. Okay, so this is really, do you want to conform to something, or do you think that it's BS and it's not for you? So let's go to Sagittarius. Sagittarius has Jupiter, Mars, and is in the MC. Okay, and this, the MC is all about your external forces, you know, you really having your own personal achievements and pursuits, and your external world, and how you relate or react to anyone that you're related to. Okay, so that's your main focus, Sagittarius. And Mercury is all about your communication and your expression and what you know, and how you organize or coordinate what you know. And Jupiter is asking you to expand yourself, okay, to grow. Where do you need to grow? Not just where you think you need to grow, but where do you really, really need to grow in your life? And being social with people. Who are you not making time for? And, you know, anything that you do will come back to you. So how are you being, how are you communicating? You know, seek insight through the knowledge you've gained already, or knowledge you need to gain, okay? Scorpio, you have Venus. Scorpio has Venus and the ninth house. Okay? Let me back up. I think Sagittarius has the 10th house, which is your achievements and your career status. So I just want to say that. Okay, so Scorpio. Scorpio has Venus and the ninth house. Venus is asking you to look at how you work, how you love, and how you handle money, okay? But also Venus is asking you about your self-care, Scorpio, asking you about your self-care, how you take care of yourself, relationship, romance, financial life. How are you balancing out your financial life when it comes to love or relationships, okay? How do you fight for what you love, what you want, you know? Maybe higher learning, maybe travel, okay? So the ninth house now is talking about, you know, how you learn, how you want to travel, where you want to go, what you want to do. Maybe some experiences with law. Maybe you have a court case coming up. Anything to do with any official writing that will be published, even spirituality, religion, maybe calling on that to help you through whatever you're going through when it comes to even traveling, law, maybe your education. What does that mean for you? Higher learning. Maybe you want to achieve something new. Okay. And you can look over to your opposite sign of Taurus if you don't relate to what is being said in your astrological reading for now, but it's so much activity in there, something's gonna click. Now Libra has the eighth house issues, which deals with how you share your resources, other people's money, money that you weren't expecting that you're getting. Maybe the new year will offer you something to do with money, other people's money returning to you. All right, so you can look over to Aries and see what's going on in Aries, which is Uranus, but I'll get to Aries later. So you can tap into that energy to help you at this full moon, all day for the full moon, right? Libra is also in this night, in this eighth house, is asking you how you let go of things, to let go of things that is not beneficial to you, right? Now let's look at Virgo. Virgo has the seventh house, and the seventh house is all about your awareness of others and maybe your partner, you know, making the relationship issues more of your focus, and partnerships more of your focus at this full moon time, moving forward towards the new moon. Maybe focus on the seventh house issues, you know, partners, awareness of others, you know, just being more aware of others more than you. And then you can look over to what's happening in Pisces house too. Pisces has a lot going on over there as well. Okay, so maybe marriages, maybe relationship with someone that you care about deeply. Okay, maybe working on that and making that better. So let's look at Leo. Leo is in the D descending part, okay, of the chart. So any kind of internal focus, maybe you feel like you want to be by yourself, Leo, maybe to think things over, and you can work on your sixth house issues, which is your daily life. Your self-improvement, really improving on yourself, will help your health, will help how you're working, and how you serve others. This is very important. And the cool thing is that you can gain that prosperity that you need, Leo, by how you change up the way you act in your daily life. All right, Cancer. Cancer has the North Node, okay? And Cancer also has the fifth house issues, okay? So the most important thing for Cancer to focus on is the energy of the full moon, because it is your moon. It's Cancer's moon, full moon in Cancer, okay? And you can make big changes with this full moon and see where your location is, what the degree is for your location, everything like that. But this is big changes that can be made, and focusing on, some of you will find a little sixth house issues, but mainly it's the fifth house issues of romance, your own personal creativity, you know, how you express yourself, how you serve through your personal creativity. Dealing with your romantic life, family, how you choose to have fun creatively. So all of this is important, but this is your full moon. And with the North Node, the focus is your life purpose. So if you've been feeling down and trying to think, okay, my life purpose, and this is for everyone. Everyone's going to be very emotional at the Cancer full moon. And think of it like the Jupiter, you know, planet of expansion, of having a mission in your life, or a calling for the future, or even for things that are unknown. You might not know where you're going, and you might feel like things might be a little bit of a challenge for you. Where are you heading? What should you be doing? What you need to learn? What will benefit you? What will increase your happiness? And it's really focusing on what you love. And maybe just doing that. It might not be your job, but it might be a creative outlet, okay? And that's just you focusing on your personal creativity at this full moon. So what can you do creatively that's fun, that will lift your spirits, okay? Gemini. So Gemini is in the area of the chart I see internal focus. So really looking at your family life, your work life, what you value, Gemini, yourself, and how are you thinking and feeling? Because you're ruled by Mercury, even though Mercury is in Sagittarius now for a while. You just want to focus, Gemini, on how you can really benefit yourself when in the fourth house issue is nurturing yourself. Nurturing yourself, your inner world, your home, your roots, your inner security, feeling secure in yourself. Maybe even your parents, maybe looking to them for guidance or, you know, the best qualities in them. And maybe if you're going through an issue, what's their wisdom for you? Anyone that's a parent figure for you. So really drawing on wisdom at this time. And there's no planets in Gemini. So really focusing on the position you are in. The internal focus. And maybe if you stay up late on the full moon at midnight, this is a great time to meditate, to not eating anything, but just being content and in meditation, and maybe just thinking and being clear about where you're going, and just use this full moon time into the new year for positive things, to uplift yourself. Taurus, third house. So this is all about how you're thinking and your immediate environment. So Taurus wants to be focusing on third house issues and strengthen yourself this way. You know, how are you thinking mentally? What have you learned? What can you learn? Communicating with your siblings and or maybe not, you know, maybe looking at your relationship with them and seeing how your relationship with them is not helping you right now in the present moment. So you can really focus on that. Aries has Uranus, which is forward thinking, which doesn't want to bend to tradition. They are really about the message for you is be still, be strong, and to focus on being in the second house at this full moon in Cancer. And focus on second house issues, which is your personal resources. You're thinking, what do I have? And so you're looking at your money mainly, more over than your skills and your values. For some of you, you might be looking more at what you own, what you possess, or the money that you're making, and really balancing that out. Maybe it's good for some of you. I feel that it's pretty good, but you are going to want to look at how you can use it for your future. Okay. And you being original or forward thinking in how you're using it, and you probably want to use it for yourself for something in the future. Maybe you should look at a better retirement or something for yourself, but you're really thinking ahead, and it's mainly for yourself, and then a little bit if it can be for something you're passionate about right now. Okay, so let me just do this. So looking at Pisces, Pisces has Neptune, Mars, and Chiron. So Neptune is all about your psychic awareness, Pisces. So tap into that this full moon, your dreams, your intuition. And then Mars is about war. It's about protection. It's about really you focusing on yourself, because you're also in the first house of Aries. So really, Pisces, you should be getting stronger within yourself, focusing on that Chiron energy. How can you heal yourself? What do you need to heal? Asking for help when you feel that, hey, I need help. Okay, so asking for that help that you need. And being in the first house, you're thinking about I am, right? You're thinking about yourself, that first house, self-awareness, and your own personal goals, and really focusing that energy on you. And, you know, using that Neptune energy to give you more clarity, okay? And that Mars energy should be used to strengthen you from within. Aquarius. Aquarius has Lilith and the 12th house, and also is in the chart area of the ascended part. So Ascended part is asking you about your personal focus, focusing on yourself and what you want to achieve, what you value, you know, about yourself. You know, it's really about you thinking about yourself and then how you reflect that to others, okay? And then, you know, with the Lilith, you can look at it like, how do you handle stressful situation, anything unexpected? How can you walk away from what is not right? So how do you handle stress? How do you handle unexpected situations? And how do you handle, you know, just walking away from whatever is not right for you, okay? And the 12th house is, you know, you can think of it as your dreams, you know, your dreams, your spiritual awareness, okay? For the 12th house, your spiritual awareness, your spiritual life, your dreams, any kind of transitions that you need to make. Try not to self-sabotage yourself, and maybe finding isolation time to yourself, or finding some way of healing, maybe going to a spa or some kind of empowering retreat, something like that. So with this triangle that we have here, this trine, with the sun, the moon, and the Mars. So the sun is in the 11th house in Capricorn, and Cancer is in the 5th house with the moon, and Aquarius is in the first house with Mars. It's like the main message now is fighting for your balance in life. You know, take your power, claim or reclaim your power for yourself, you know. And when you're doing this, it's for your own personal business, or it could be for your home, finding compassion for yourself to strengthen you, either in the business world for your work or at home, wherever you feel, or both, you know. And this is for future thinkers, for what you're passionate about, okay? And for future generations, if you have a family, you're strengthening yourself at this moon for them as well. So I hope you enjoyed this reading. Thank you guys so much for listening. Peace. Yeah.